Whisper Gaming ASMR. I believe this is episode 7 of my Diablo 4 open beta playthrough, and is more likely than not the last episode of this series. I think this will be the last time I get the chance to play this game before the beta ends. Starting off with a lot of wolf action. I wonder if... Sorry, still messing with the audio levels. I wonder if the werewolf character model is the same as the prowler character model. They look very similar. Just looks... The prowler seems slightly more hunched over. But yeah, this is... Most likely the last time I'll play this beta, because it ends tomorrow at, I think, noon Pacific, which is 3 o'clock Eastern, and I have a big day at work tomorrow, plus I need to pack for my trip back home, so I don't think I'm going to have any chance to play. So my goal in this video is to get to level 20, so I can unlock those cosmetic rewards for when the final game comes out. Granted that I actually buy it. Also just realized I don't think I ever repaired my armor after I died in the last episode, so I was trying to check out that durability when these rude-ass prowlers interrupted me. Yeah, my durability. What does durability even do? Does it make it less effective? Like, is it worth running back to town for? Whatever. I think we'll be fine. Also hoping we don't get too many weird throat sounds. My girlfriend and I did a nacho and margarita night a couple hours ago, which was a tradition for us for a while. We'd do it every, I think, Tuesday night or Wednesday night. Then we kind of got out of it for a while. Behold, the truth lies within. Is there something I'm supposed to do there? But anyway, we brought back the tradition tonight, so I just ate a ton of nachos and a margarita, or drank margarita, so I'm pretty full and hoping that does not negatively impact this video too much. So in the last video, we murdered this Nirelis. We murdered her mother. Like I said, it's a pretty big day at work tomorrow. I have my first annual review at my job tomorrow morning with my boss. So, yeah, I would like to get a decent night's sleep. Plus, I want to get up early, so I have time to practice a little music before work. Even though I am considering maybe taking tomorrow off from playing music. I don't know, I'm in a weird spot. I've been working on learning some songs that my grandfather's wanted me to play for a while. Part of the reason I'm going home to see my grandfather is because he was recently diagnosed with melanoma, which hopefully isn't too serious. It was on his fingertip, which they had to amputate part. part of his finger, which isn't ideal, but I guess if you're going to get something amputated, it's probably one of the better things. He has his non-dominant hand and just kind of the tip of it. But anyway, he's been wanting me to learn some songs for a while, so it seemed like a good motivator to finally learn them. I'll return to this story after doing this. I need a holy blessing to continue chasing Lilith. Of course she's somewhere else. Songs he's wanted me to play. I have them down okay, like I can play them, but they're not the greatest, and I'm definitely my own harshest critic, so I wish they're a little better. So I don't know, it's just making me feel weird musically that, I don't know, I don't think they're good enough for me. Hopefully, I'm sure they'll be good enough for him. And then I'm also meeting up with a few friends that I haven't seen in quite a while that I used to be in a band with, and they're in another band together, and they're making some really good music, so I'm looking forward to seeing them, and I'm really looking forward to jamming with them. Cries of the Innocence. Where was the boy who's taken to the Black Asylum, and now he haunts me every moment, calling to me, begging that I don't know how much more I can stand. Supposed to do here. God, there's some dark ass quests in this game. I guess I'll give them some credit for their dark writing. Because I kind of like dark stuff. Okay, well, if I come across that, I guess I'll do that quest. But yeah, so I'm meeting up with my friends that I was in a band with. They're still in the band. I took like 10 years off from playing music after that band kind of broke apart. There's no drama or anything. It's just like we're in high school and we ended up going to college and we're just in different areas. So I'm excited to meet up with them and jam with them and talk with them, but also feeling a little weird because they've all been playing music for the past 10 years plus. I was definitely the weakest member of the band, or at least I thought I was. I'm pretty sure I was, but it was my own fault. I didn't put in much effort at all in high school. At that point in my life, my main interest was girls, so putting effort into music was not the top of my priority list. Like, I was naturally decent. I wouldn't say I was amazing, but that's pretty good for the little amount of effort I put in. So yeah, they already were better than me to start with, and they've played for the past 10 years, whereas I didn't. And then I'm starting on brand new instruments, so I don't know, I just feel weird. Like, not self-conscious is the right word, but just kind of like kicking myself and regretting that I took 10 years off from playing and thinking about like how further ahead I'd be if I would have been playing music this whole time and had been putting in effort back then, since I did have so much potential as a kid. If I actually tried, I could have been really good. But you can't change the past. And everything happens for a reason, so maybe if I would have stuck with it, there's some unforeseen negative consequence that would have come from it. But yeah, so exciting things, but also with some weird baggage attached coming these next few days. So I guess how I got on this whole ramble was I've just been feeling weird musically about it, because I'm like putting pressure on myself to get these songs good for my grandfather. And then my friends that I'm meeting up with just released a couple singles off an album they just recorded, and I'm trying to train my ear better, because I don't know much about music theory, and I've never been the best at just like figuring things out by ear. So I've been trying to listen to the songs they released and trying to learn them by ear, but it's more difficult than I expected. So I've been struggling with figuring that out, which is frustrating. And yeah, so I'm like, I should practice more tomorrow because it's the last day I have to practice. But at the same, and I want to practice a lot today, but again, talked about in a previous video, like this weird resistance. I think it might have been earlier today, because I recorded a video this morning. I didn't practice as much as I would have liked to. And then when I finally did get myself focused and practicing the songs I need to work on, my like fingers are sore from playing 12-string guitar. I felt like I was losing my breath a lot while singing, which seems to randomly happen sometimes. And I just feel like my practice today wasn't very good, so part of me wants to try to squeeze in practice tomorrow, but then another part of me is saying maybe that's an indicator that I just need to rest. And I'm thinking that's probably the better strategy. But then I always have those doubts in the back of my head of like, that's just you giving yourself an excuse to be lazy. So I don't know, I always double and triple guess myself. But I do think maybe I should, if I do practice tomorrow, take it easy so my fingers and voice and stuff aren't really sore for when I finally do have a chance to play with my friends. Now that I'm kind of saying this all out loud to myself, I definitely should rest, I think, because the chance to play with my friends doesn't come very often. And the amount of progress I'm realistically going to be able to make tomorrow is probably pretty minimal. Plus, I do have the second class of my vocal workshop class, whatever I'm taking is tomorrow night, so I'll definitely be practicing music there. So yeah, I should take it easy, give my fingers a rest. And sometimes by taking days off, you make more progress than pushing through. So yeah, I'm glad I just talked that out with myself. Hopefully that wasn't too brutal of commentary for you to listen to. Plus, I have a lot to do tomorrow. I have a lot of work, and then I need to completely pack for my trip home, because I did not get the packing today. And I'm not a light packer. I chronically overpack for things, so I'm sure that will take a while. busy day, and then I have an 8 or 9 hour drive, hopefully. It's only 8 or 9 hours depending on traffic. A long drive ahead of me on Tuesday. And then I'm still working while I'm at my parents' house, so I then need to squeeze 4 days of work. I mean 5 days of work into 4 days. While also working from a non-ideal environment. Since I'm gonna wanna visit with my grandparents. And I typically work with two monitors, but I'm only gonna have one monitor. And yeah. It's just gonna not be ideal. So it's gonna be a busy next week, but I'm excited to go home to see my family and friends back home. And yeah, that should be good. But that's what's going on in my life. Thought I'd do some commentary that wasn't related to the channel, because I typically talk about what's coming up on the channel, and thought I'd change that. But on that note, I did earlier today upload, like a couple hours ago, upload the first 3 videos of the series, so those are live. We'll see if they get many views. And then I have 3 more videos edited and uploaded. I just need to work on the thumbnails and descriptions and stuff. And I'm gonna release one of those. I'm gonna release one every day for the next however many days once I get this one edited. Should be for the next 4 days. And then I should have a couple more Minecraft videos coming. And then probably either a Metroid or Stardew Valley. Plus I have those Deep Rock Galactic videos recorded that I wanna release. And then when I get back from traveling, I plan to finally record a Grand Theft Auto 5 online video. And probably get the Cobblemon Minecraft mod installed. And then record some videos of that. And then probably go back to Slime Rancher and record some Slime Rancher videos. But I then need to revisit some of the games I recorded, because I haven't played Metroid Prime or Stardew Valley in quite a while, so I need to get back to those. Especially Metroid Prime, because someone has said they like that series a lot. And plus my friend that recommended it keeps asking me if I've played it anymore, and I haven't. And I'm torn about that, because I'm going to be home and I'm going to bring my Nintendo Switch, and my parents both go to bed pretty early, and I'm a night owl, so I'm usually alone at night with not much to do, especially because the internet at my parents' house is extremely, extremely slow. It's basically like dial-up, so I can't do much aside from like streaming Netflix, which even sometimes that doesn't work. So I do want to play more Metroid Prime while I'm home, but then that's going to mess up the series, because my video isn't going to, it's going to be missing some parts of the game, so not sure how I'm going to handle that yet. I'm torn between trying to record. I might be able to bring home enough stuff so I can like stream it through my laptop and like just play by watching the gameplay on OBS. I don't know how that'll work. Plus I'm not gonna have like my microphone set up, so I might try to do it with like a cheaper head, like either my AirPods or like one of those cheap microphones that are on like the wired, like old. old school Apple headphone setups. We'll see. Or I might just play it and then pick up my recordings like further in the game. So yeah, I'm torn on that. To be determined. But if you're someone that's a fan of that series, well, I guess by the time this gets released, I'll already be home. But if I do end up playing through it without recording, I hope you don't get too upset that some parts of the game are missing. I wish there's a way to like have to like save it, like duplicate my save so I could come back to it for my recording, but I don't think there's that option. But I am glad that I have so many videos recorded, so I have a little bit of wiggle room. I think I did the math, and I have right now if I release 2 videos per week. Because I did one with gameplay audio and one without. After releasing those 3 today, and then if I release 1 Diablo video every day for the next few days, and then after that, after I upload those, go back to my normal schedule of uploading on Sundays and Wednesdays, and then I have 7 weeks worth of content already recorded. So I'm already like 2 months ahead, which is a bit of a double-edged sword, because it's nice that I don't have the pressure of I could take off a week or two of recording and still be fine, but it does suck that there's so much lag time on my videos. So I'm still like uploading videos that I recorded a month ago, where I feel like the quality isn't quite as good. In my commentary, I'm still talking about launching my channel, so I feel like there's a little bit of a weird continuity there, but hopefully that doesn't bother you too much. So yeah, there's trade-offs for everything, I guess. This chest has something good. No legendaries. That must be better though. Oh, way better. Wow, my amulet sucks. So literally, holy arrows, Jesus. Oh god. Wow, that's insane. Executed. Oh, is that the thing I get if it's like an undamaged enemy or something, I randomly execute them? Something along those lines. Hellcaller Wrathful Phantom. Interesting name. guess I'll check my journal a second. I'm almost to level 19 at least, so once I hit level 20, I will probably call it there, but I think that's going to take a decent amount of time still. So I think this will definitely be a 45 minute, yeah, easily be 45 minutes. I'll be lucky if it's not an hour and a half, I think. As well. I don't think it really matters. I keep going back and forth on how I feel about this game. It definitely is a lot of just like mindlessly clicking. I'm sure that changes in higher difficulties when you get further in the game. To a certain extent, that's how all Diablo games are, but I don't know, I just can't tell if this is good or not. Like, if I would enjoy this for a long time. I do think I would enjoy it a little more if I wasn't recording these videos, just because it'd give me more of a chance to focus on the storylines and stuff like that. And I feel like I'm missing out on some of the stuff by having the music and all the sound effects turned down. Kinda torn about that too, like I said in a previous video, before I started recording these ASMR videos, I wasn't really playing video games at all. But the reason I wanted to start playing games again was I was having a hard time finding stuff to do to relax. I always felt like I needed to be doing something productive, or I kinda felt guilty. And then when I would actually just relax and, like, do something mindless, like watching a movie or playing a video game, it just felt, like, unfulfilling. And I'm like, I would have just preferred to have done something productive. And that's why I decided to make these videos, because I'm like, oh, I get to play a video game, but I'm still kind of being productive, and all I have to do is talk to myself. Which is not that difficult for me, because I like to talk. But now it's like, this isn't really that relaxing of an activity, because there's like expectations tied to it, and I have to edit things and create thumbnails and upload, and it adds a layer of pressure. So I'm like, I don't know. I feel like I still have the same problem of, like, so what do I really do to relax? And now I, like, feel like I can't even play a video game without recording a video, because it seems like a waste. It's like, if I'm already playing a video game, is it really that much harder to record it and talk to myself? So it's just, like, such a low level of extra effort, where I'm like, now I really can't justify just playing a video game to enjoy it, which I guess that's more of a me problem and something I should get over. But yeah, and I think I could solve it, because I was playing. Why the fuck was that guy already almost dead? I was playing Age of Empires 2 Remastered with some of my friends for a while, and I think if I was playing games with friends, it would let me relax and enjoy it without feeling guilty about not recording. But at my age, which I mean isn't that old, but I'm almost 29, my friends are in their late 20s, early 30s, and some of them have kids and stuff now. It is a lot harder to coordinate schedules. And, yeah, so that's also another issue, because it's hard for me to play games with friends now. I think it's like, maybe 2 or 3 weeks we played together once or twice a week, and that kind of fell off because we couldn't. It's hard for us to fit to coordinate our schedules. But maybe if I get enough videos recorded ahead, I can justify playing some games without recording them and not feel guilty about it. Or I could just have, oh, nice, legendary ring, sec. And I am stuck in a wall. Or I guess I could have some games that aren't very ASMR friendly, that are just dedicated to me relaxing when I play them. I don't know. I guess I'm getting pretty personal in this video, so I don't know if that's a good legendary shit right before I never play this character again. And what do I get after killing an enemy with Shredder next to werewolf skill generates? 21% more spirit. It deals 21% increased damage, plus I have an empty socket. Resistance, poison resistance, shatter resistance. Fuck it, let's throw that bad boy in there. Stuff says account bound, it just makes me way less likely to drop it. I guess it really doesn't matter. All this shit is, I'm never gonna play this again, so. Or this character at least. Guys, is that door gonna unlock? God, I feel a sneeze coming on. These corpse bows are annoying. The door has been unsealed. Guess those things don't count as enemies. Let's go see what's behind this door. Better be something good, because it's a long ass fucking dungeon. Yeah, Jesus Christ, those hanging legs. Resurrected malice. It seems like every boss is basically the same. This is like the same attack rotation as the boss I fought yesterday. Like spooky skulls that fly around. The circle around it that slows you and fucks you up. Shit. tells us knows that the dungeon does not scale with you and you level up inside the dungeon. Since it seems like she's still level 18, even though I'm level 19. My tea drinkable. Okay, no more distractions. We're going straight to this quest. Maybe doing like a world event if it's along the way. Stopped. What is the gather spirit anima from the undead? God damn it. God fucking damn it. What the hell does that even mean? Thank you. hippopotamus or treasure goblins or whatever that were in the third one. You'd chase them down and they'd drop good shit, and then they'd like open the port. You'd have to kill them before they opened the portal. And then sometimes if you got like really lucky, you could go through the portal and it brought you to this like treasure world. I think there's another portal too. I remember I went through and there were like unicorns and shit to fight. That was pretty cool. Fucking side quests. Something good in it. Better have something good in it. Sorry, I'm in like such a salty mood tonight. It's just like, it's been a long weekend and I have a long week ahead of me. And fuck you. Side quest. We're going back. I do want to know why all this gold is just randomly like scattered on the ground. Is it like leading somewhere? This is a world event. You know what? I don't care. We have a story quest to do. Halfway to 19. Dexterity is increased by 2 for all characters on this realm. Stupid staff I probably don't want. Why the hell did this lady go all the way up here? Seems like a pretty low level. level of security. Are these all the people that we found dead in that tomb? This fucking loser with me. I'm gonna probably just skip through these cutscenes and stuff. Blessing to chase Lilith. I can't even skip this. This war is holy. Lilith has brought the eternal conflict to sanctuary, and in Aris will deliver us as writ in prophecy. Then we have our parts to play. Make a pilgrimage to the Alabaster Monastery, Clear Spirit. Then we may discuss, but of course, there's another step. Why does there have to be another step? Jesus Christ, and no fucking experience. So negative, but I just want to hit level 20 so I can finish this game. And if I do end up buying it, I'm gonna have to replay all this anyway, so I feel okay about rushing through it now. And I didn't sell any of my shit, so fuck. Not even a waypoint in this area. That seems kinda dumb. Did I miss something? There has to be a waypoint in Calvera. Is there really nothing here? a waste of time if I just ran back here, and there's really no waypoint. And there is not. That sucks. Shit, when I get to this shrine. I just want to teleport things so I can go back to that town and turn in that quest I completed to get the experience I'm owed. Your destination. Oh, that's because I set a waypoint. Oh god, I was not looking at my health. And I don't have any keys. Shit, now it's God, I feel like I'm so negative this video. I really do apologize if that's the case. I'm just tired. But it's my choice to record this video right now, so I should stop bitching. Of the faithful, no one. I would like to see the people that come up with all these quests and stuff, though. There's like, okay, now you click on that. Well, I guess you can boil any video game down to that, but click on this, and then you walk here, but everything's red and you can't see. And then you go and do it again, and then I'm sure after this there'll be a third one to do. And hopefully there won't be a fourth. But we'll see. Seems like they're padding this game out a decent amount. And then there's a really strong boss that takes 20 minutes to beat on the last one. It's me at this altar. Resources. I'm literally gonna hit level 20 and then be done with this. So, God, I guess just human nature. Even if it's some virtual shit that literally has no meaning or value in the grand scheme of things, you still want to pick it up. Like, as I'm bitching about it, I do it again. Oh God. Oh God. I really do not want to die right now. Place, fuck. Okay, immobilize, fuck, fuck. God damn it. Oh, that was close. Oh my God, oh. also think this is ridiculous, or am I just being salty? Okay, at least this one. It's like not, okay. If this is just like normal to end it, I was prematurely salty, I will admit. Nope, fuck you guys. I'm climbing up. To get a little earlier before. Am I gonna have to fight this guy? This guy has a lot of repressed shit to deal with. So I had to do all that shit and this guy just had to sit here and pray. That seems unfair. I owe you a stiff drink. So close to level 20. You know what, we're not gonna take the path less traveled, we're going straight. This main quest. I bet it's gonna get me, I'm gonna be like right below leveling up when I complete this. Where's my cool ass helmet? The angels in the Diablo universe are so scary. Resolution, only more pain. What are they fighting over? I'm sorry if this commentary sucks this video. With your blessing, I can pursue her. Audience is concluded. What's he doing here all day? Just chilling, look at the picture of himself on the wall. God, why are the angels in this universe like such pretentious dicks? I knew it. next quest will do the trick. And then I'll probably unlock a bunch of cool shit for hitting level 20. And I'll be done at that point, so it won't even matter. You got done was giving me some healing potions for my troubles. Well, ask and you shall receive. Collect every common and uncommon resource, I'm assuming, is what that says. Prepared harvester title. It looks like I'm not gonna complete that. I'll turn in that quest I completed for killing that guy's son. Also, I didn't watch any videos on the druid. I wonder how the druid class stacks up to the other classes. I saw like video thumbnails that said sorcerer and I think necromancer are like pretty broken. From the little coverage of this game that I did look at, it seems like, well, I mentioned this in another video, but seems like ranged classes have a huge advantage. Which I do wonder how PvP is going to be in this game. I feel like it's not going to be very balanced. Seen in this game, these blessings and the light don't seem to be that powerful. Level 20, nice. And now I can do gem crafting. Let's get one more upgrade that I'm never gonna use. Upgrade my wolves. Stuff like that. salty, so please forgive me. Maybe you can relate to some of those feelings, so I hope that's the case. As always, if you watch this video to fall asleep, I hope you aren't hearing any of this.